Okay, guys, today I'm gonna show you how to make a really cheap Easter basket using a milk jug, or this is a water jug. Okay, so if you do use a milk jug, you do want to make sure it's rinsed out really well. If you have an adult to help you, you may want to rinse it out with a little bit of bleach or vinegar, either one, but make sure you get an adult to help you with that, okay? Because otherwise, that milk stays in there and it kind of sours and makes a bad smell. So today, I've already drawn, I don't know if you can see, I've drawn a little kind of jelly bean shape on the milk jug. And I'm going to poke my scissors really carefully in there, and then I'm going to cut that out. Okay. Now, I've made this before and not left enough space at the bottom. This bottom part is going to be your basket part. So if you have a lot of things, or plan on getting a lot of things, you may want to make this a little bit wider. Okay. So this is going to be a bunny eventually. This bottom part is the mouth, and the top part is the head or the eyes. Okay, and then this inside is your basket. So I'm going to cut this out real quick. I've already made my hole inside the milk jug so that I can just put my scissors in there and just cut it out. Now, again, you may need to get an adult to help you with this. So make sure that someone in your home knows that you're doing this. Okay. All right. So I'm cutting this out. And if you decide that you need more space, you can cut either more at the top or more at the bottom. Okay. So this inside right here is going to be your basket. All right. Next, you're going to get a bunch of cotton balls, and I mean a bunch, okay? And then you're just going to take them, dip them in glue, and then you're just going to put them starting at the top all around your basket, okay? All around your little milk jug here. Now I'm going to work on this, and then I'm going to come back and show you the finished product, and then we'll finish, okay? So I covered this completely with cotton balls. Okay, and I'm going to show you. It doesn't have ears or an eyes or a nose yet, so let me show you how to do that. And let me show you too real quick. One of the things that I did that I think makes the cotton balls go a little bit farther is that before I put the cotton ball on, I kind of pull it a little bit and stretch it. And then I put it in glue, okay? And that kind of makes it like this probably takes up the space of two cotton balls not pulled, okay? So it does take a lot of cotton balls, probably about a half a bag of cotton balls to cover this whole thing. I did not cover the handle. I have done in here before, but I just thought, hey, that would make it easier to hold. So I left a spot right here. You can see some glue running down there. And what I did was, is I'm going to take the cotton ball that I have. I wanted the tail to kind of stick out, and not just blend in with the other cotton balls. So I wanted the tail to have a little pink on it. You don't have to do this, and you could do it with blue or red or any color really. So I'm just kind of touching it slightly with my marker, and that gives it kind of a pink tail. And then I'm gonna take my cotton ball. Ooh, I'm losing part of it. Okay, that I dipped in glue. I'm gonna put him down there, and then he'll or she one will have a little pink tail. Okay. Then I have some more space right here, so I may go back in and add some more cotton balls in there too. So I made two ears. Okay, I just did this out of construction paper so that it would stand up a little bit. You could do it out of cardstock. You could even do it out of a cereal box if you wanted to. And I left again some more space right here for the ears, and then I'll put some cotton balls over there once I add the ears. Now, I did put the lid on the jug and I added a cotton ball to the top of it. You don't have to do that again, but you can. So I'm going to take my ears, I'm dipping them in a little bit of glue. Then I put them right here. Let me tilt this down so you can see a little bit of what I'm doing. Okay, there's my two ears. And then back here, okay, where I have some space, I'm gonna take and cover up so you can't see the back of the ear there. There you go. I spread it out. I probably put another one right there as well. Okay, then I'm going to do the same thing on this side right here. Another thing you could do if you don't want it, sometimes when I dip this in the glue, the cotton ball, it kind of gets stringy and I leave some of the cotton ball in the glue. You could take a paintbrush, an old paintbrush, and paint the glue on, and that is also a good way. Now here, I have my ears, all right? Now I'm gonna add my eyes, and just like before, I used it on construction paper. Again, you could make them on anything that you wanted. Okay. And I'm kind of doing this backwards. I can't really see you very well. Hopefully, I'm putting them in the right spot. Okay. So these are my little eyes. And then the teeth. Now, let me just tell you, when I first made the teeth, I made them the size that I would want them sticking out. So I made them this size. Then I realized when I go to glue them underneath behind, you're not going to see much of them. So I made my next set of teeth extra long so that when I put them up underneath here, I'm doing this backwards, so sorry. When I put them underneath there, they're hanging down enough that you can see. Okay. Now, it's also an option if you want to put some down here, you can, but you don't have to. I'm going to go ahead and do that. Okay. And the same thing, I made them extra long. Oh, I have some glue dripping. I made them extra long so that you could see them. Now, you might not want to put teeth down below, especially if you're going to be taking in and out eggs and grass and stuff. Okay. Then for the nose, I colored it pink. You can color it with, you could even paint it with pink marker crayon, or you could paint it, like I said. And then just kind of put it right here. Now, I'm not putting whiskers on, but you could take some yarn and put some whiskers on if you wanted. Whoops, sorry. Again, I'm putting it on upside down. Okay, there you go. Now, here is, let me hold it back so you can see. Here's your cute little basket. And this, I love this because baskets are kind of expensive, and a lot of times they just end up getting thrown away anyway. So, this is your cute little bunny basket. Okay, I did not add feet to him, but you could if you wanted. But again, you want it durable where when you're going around, it's not going to fall apart. Okay, and all this glue, I do have some glue dripping. When it dries, it will just dry clear and you won't be able to see the drips. All right, if you wanted to, you could put a bow tie, or I mean a bow up here in its ears if it was going to be a girl, or if it's a boy, you could put a bow tie down here. Totally up to you. All right. So, if you do this project, I'd love to see how they turn out. So, take a picture of it and send it to me, all right? I hope you guys love this. Talk to you soon.